B-21 Raider bomber is a symbol of the evolution of the United States air strategy and military technology. As a new generation strategic bomber, the B-21 Raider carries great expectations to replace and complement the role of two previous legendary bombers, namely the B-2 Spirit and B-52 Stratofortress. These three aircraft, although coming from different eras, have the same purpose, ensuring the United States air dominance in the face of global threat. We will discuss a comprehensive comparison between the B-21 Raider, B-2 Spirit, and B-52 Stratofortress, covering aspects of technology, operational capabilities, financing, and strategic roles. Since the introduction of the B-52 Stratofortress in 1955, it has been the backbone of the United States Strategic Bomber Force. With a conventional design that prioritizes large payload, the B-52 can carry up to 3,150 kg of payload, including nuclear and conventional weapons. Although it has undergone significant modernization, including updates to its avionics, engines, and communication systems, its basic technology remains from the 1950s. With non-stealth materials and traditional design, the B-52 is highly vulnerable to modern air defense radar and missile systems. Then, in the late 1990s, the B-2 Spirit introduced revolutionary stealth technology. This aircraft uses a flying wing design that minimizes radar and thermal signatures, allowing the B-2 to penetrate heavily defended enemy airspace. Radar-absorbent materials and advanced navigation systems make the B-2 difficult to detect by conventional radar. However, the complexity of this technology comes at a high cost. The cost of its development and maintenance has limited the number of B-2s produced to only 21 units. The B-21 Raider is a result of learning from the challenges faced by its predecessors. The aircraft utilizes advanced stealth technologies, including new composite materials that are lighter and more effective at absorbing radar waves. Its modular design allows for frequent technology upgrades without the need for major overhauls, making it ready to counter modern threats such as multi-spectrum radars and artificial intelligence-based anti-stealth systems. In addition, the B-21 is designed to be more energy efficient, increasing its operational efficiency. In terms of communications and sensor technology, the B-21 is equipped with systems that enable interoperability with advanced command and control networks. This is critical in modern warfare that increasingly relies on cross-domain integration, including cyberspace and space. The B-21 is also designed to accommodate the development of hypersonic weapons, which are expected to be a key part of future military strategy. The operational capabilities of these three aircraft reflect the different strategic priorities of each era. The B-52 Stratofortress, with a range of up to 1,400 kg without refueling, is an ideal tool for long-range missions. It can fly across continents, carrying a variety of weapons, including long-range cruise missiles that can be launched from beyond the range of enemy air defense systems. However, its operational capabilities are limited to low to medium threat air defense environments. In situations where sophisticated radar systems are used, the B-52 is vulnerable to detection and destruction. In contrast, the B-2 Spirit is designed for long-range stealth missions. It can carry up to 18 tons of weapons, including precision bombs and nuclear weapons, to strike heavily defended targets. This capability has been proven in various military operations, such as in Kosovo, Iraq, and Afghanistan. Although effective, the B-2 requires significant logistical support and a complex maintenance infrastructure, making it less flexible than the B-52. The B-21 Raider aims to combine the advantages of both. With better stealth than the B-2 and operational efficiency approaching that of the B-52, the B-21 is capable of operating in a variety of battlefields. It is also designed to perform missions autonomously or semi-autonomously, allowing for more flexible operations in complex electronic warfare environments. The B-21's operational range is estimated to be comparable to the B-2, but with higher fuel efficiency, allowing for longer mission times. Another advantage of the B-21 is its ability to operate in high-level electronic warfare scenarios. The aircraft is equipped with electronic warfare devices to disrupt enemy radar and communication systems, providing a tactical advantage in combat situations that demand speed and precision. Financing has always been a major challenge in strategic bomber development. The B-52 Stratofortress, despite its Cold War roots, has proven to be one of the most cost-efficient bombers to operate. Its longevity, extended through various modernization programs, suggests that large initial investments can pay off through long-term operational efficiencies. The same cannot be said for the B-2 Spirit, however. With a development cost of $44.75 billion and a unit price tag of about $2 billion, the B-2 program has faced criticism for its cost overruns that far exceeded initial estimates, especially for its environmentally sensitive stealth materials. With the B-21 Raider, the Air Force is trying to avoid the same mistakes with a more efficient production approach. The B-21's development and production costs are projected to be lower than those of the B-2, although it remains an expensive program with a total estimated cost of $203 billion over its lifetime. One strategy to keep costs down is the use of modular technology that allows upgrades without requiring the entire aircraft to be replaced. Skepticism remains, however, especially given the potential for budget overruns due to unforeseen technical or geopolitical challenges. In addition, the B-21 is expected to provide greater long-term value by reducing the need for replacement aircraft for decades to come. Its modularity makes it more flexible to adapt to new threats, including the development of hypersonic weapons and increasingly sophisticated combat drones. These three bombers serve different strategic roles, but all aim to maintain the United States air dominance. The B-52 Stratofortress has been the backbone of the nuclear deterrent strategy for more than six decades. It has been used extensively in air patrol and strategic strike missions during major conflicts, including the Vietnam War, the Gulf War, and Operation Enduring Freedom. The B-52's role in maintaining a strategic presence in conflict zones remains relevant today, especially with the addition of modern cruise missiles. The B-2 Spirit, the world's first stealth bomber, plays a critical role in precision strike missions against heavily defended enemy targets. It is often used to attack strategic infrastructure, such as nuclear facilities and military bases. Its ability to carry nuclear weapons also makes it a key element in the United States nuclear triad. The B-21 Raider, on the other hand, is designed to be the backbone of the future air strategy. with multi-dome capabilities that include integration with space and cyberspace technologies, the B-21 is expected to be able to counter threats from rival nations such as China and Russia. The B-21's strategic roles include stealth operations, precision strikes, and support for electronic warfare, making it a highly flexible tool in modern war scenarios. In addition, the B-21 is also designed to contribute to unconventional operations, including counter-terrorism missions and precision strikes against enemy logistics networks. With the ability to carry more advanced weapons, such as directed energy weapons, the B-21 has the potential to be a versatile strike platform on the future battlefield. In an era of increasing concern for sustainability, strategic bomber programs face pressure to reduce their environmental impact. The B-52 Stratofortress continues to be upgraded with more efficient engines to reduce carbon emissions and fuel consumption. This modernization program is part of an effort to keep the aircraft relevant without significantly increasing its environmental footprint. The B-2 Spirit, though newer, was designed before environmental concerns were a priority. Its operations require more fuel per mission than other non-stealth aircraft. The B-21 Raider, on the other hand, was designed with more energy-efficient technology, including more efficient engines and lighter materials. However, efforts to make it more environmentally friendly remain challenging, especially given the nature of its military mission that prioritizes effectiveness over sustainability. All three bombers play a critical role in shaping global geopolitical dynamics. The B-52 Stratofortress, with its iconic presence, is often used on strategic patrol missions aimed at demonstrating U.S. military power in sensitive areas such as the South China Sea and the Korean Peninsula. The aircraft serves as an effective military diplomacy tool, sending a strong message to competitors without direct escalation. The B-2 Spirit, with its stealth technology, is more often used for covert operations in enemy territory. Its use in conflicts such as Kosovo and Iraq demonstrated its effectiveness in weakening enemy positions without engaging in frontal combat. The presence of the B-2 also has a psychological effect, given its ability to strike targets without warning. The B-21 Raider, as a next-generation bomber, is expected to have a greater impact in modern geopolitics. Its multi-dome design allows integration with strategies involving space and cyberspace, making it more than just a bomber platform. Its presence also triggers a technology race among rival countries, such as China and Russia, which are seeking to develop anti-stealth defense systems or equivalent bombers. The B-21 Raider is not just a new bomber, but a representation of the future of U.S. air strategy. With more advanced technology, greater cost efficiency, and unmatched operational flexibility, the B-21 offers a solution to 21st century military challenges. Compared to the B-52 Stratofortress and B-2 Spirit, the B-21 combines the strengths of both while addressing their weaknesses. While funding challenges remain a concern, this major investment is a critical step toward ensuring that the United States remains superior in air warfare and maintains its position as the world's leading military power.